Alright guys, what's this video about? If you like me, like way too practical woman, that's who I consider myself to be. And well, if you like me and you like to change fitted sheet more often as you fit a top sheet, well, you can. This video is for you. And what I mean, why I change fitted sheet more often as I use, as I change top sheet? Because you know mattresses are so expensive these days. And if you like me, a little bit older, and it's matter, quality of mattresses matter. And good quality mattress like memory foams, they come up with really good. You know those under vacuum, they sell in a roll memory foam. They're not that expensive. But if you low income people like me are, $200 for a mattress, what we just spent on memory foam by from Walmart. It's 8 inches thicker, but it's we are overweighted people, we are old people, and it's working so good for more than 1 year. Absolutely, I do suggest it's the best $200 we spent last year. No, well, buy it because they so much better. Get rid of your old mattress. I don't care how you much sort or anything else we had before, all of them. Those deep, heavy boxed mattresses, get rid of them. Get memory foam. And again, I believe it was $229 from Walmart. Only 8 inches. Is higher foam will be, as heavy as will be for you to carry it, to put on your bed. And well, it's going to be probably better, but it's $400, which is we don't have. No, well, $230 did very good for us. And well, but we have to keep it because you don't want to spend it every second year. You don't want, other words, you do need still mattress cover for that. You do need a nice padded mattress cover, even for foam mattress. But on the top of it, fitted sheet has to be changed more often because, you know, when you use that sheet even over one season, like 3-4 months, no matter how good you wash it, no matter how much stain remover you put in it, we dry outside everything to have that fresh smell from air and sun. But still, it's kind of worn out if you're using 100 cotton only like we do. That's why I prefer to, and they don't sell fitted sheets. They sell extra top sheets. No, well, that's why this video about how to make a fitted sheet out of top sheet. No, well, what you do first, you put all the four corners of your top sheet. This is a queen size, and no matter what size you have it, it's about the same ways of doing it. No, well, put all four corners together, pin it, make sure it's all four, make sure pin it like about 20 inches in this way and 20 inches in this way. Make sure all four layers is here, not three, because it's easy to start here with four, and then somewhere here got to only pin it two or three. No, well, make sure they all pin it, and then pin it through right here, like that in a circle. Make sure what when you will cut all four of them at once. Now, again, doesn't matter how deep is your mattress is, I do not suggest you to cut here more as probably 12 inches up this way, and 12 inches this way, and then just connect, make that square, make that square, and that's it. You're done with your patterns. That's it. Cut it out like that, this square, and then get rid of all these pins, and all what you need just to stitch. You don't need overlock machine. We're gonna run what you call French seam. I will go to machine right now and show to you how to do it. By the way, if you don't have sewing machine, you can do by hands, but better have machine for this job because you also have to put elastic on it. And well, just get rid of these pins. Let's go to machine and I will show to you how to finish up. It's really, really easy. All right guys, here we are by sewing machine, and let me show to you what we call French seam, how escape use an overlocker for projects like that, for little stitching like that. Well, here is your corner what we cut, right here, your square corner what we cut. You have to put these things together, but put these things back to back of sheet. With this pattern hard to see because it's solid color, but with some pattern sheets you will be able to see it. No, well, but anyway, you remember this detail on the top sheet? It's always going on the top. No, well, this is my front and this is my front. And I put back to back together. And now I stitch I stitch this together, well, two corners what I cut, it stitched together, but I stitch them from the front, against my logic. And I make seam as small as possible, such as like only 2 millimeters seam. If it's hard for you to make 2 millimeters, make 1/4 inch, okay? For this project, it actually doesn't matter. Now, you turn opposite way, and whenever you did with here, do it more, at least twice more, what you make sure what nothing, no raving will be from another side. Do it here, if I did 1/4 inch there, I'm doing 1/2 inch here. Okay, that's what you got, that's on the back of your sheet. Now turn back and look. No raving here, no nothing, this is your front. This is your front and this is a corner which will go over your mattress. If it's, that's why I decided, if it's too big for your foam mattress, like too big for my 8 inches one, don't worry about it. Foam mattress is really easy to tack in under that corner if its corner is 8 inches and you cut actually 11. I prefer to go under to make sure my fitted sheet is nice and tight, staying good. Now we just need to put elastic. Let me show you how to do that. Now, elastics. First of all, which elastic to choose? I do have special video about elastics, why they worn out, how to prevent worn out elastics, and I'm placing that right above my talking and also in the end of this video, what you will be available to watch it for those who do not subscribe, because I have more than 200 videos on my channel. Even for subscribers, it's very hard to navigate unless you go playlist by playlist. It's like 2 dozen playlists there as well. Now, well, check it out. Go on the homepage and scroll down and check out one playlist one by one. But anyway, let me, if I repeating for those who saw that elastic video already, please forgive me, because my task to put everybody to sewing and spread as much knowledge of my 50 years of sewing as possible. And elastics what you choose for this kind of project will be no less than 1/2 inch. If you choose this tiny one, 1/4 inch, especially polyester one like what I'm stretching right now, it will worn out in no time, because you do wash it every week, at least minimum wash it every week. Between cotton elastic vintage one and polyester one 1/2 inch, I will choose of course cotton, because stretchability. This is going to be too stiff, and it's again in washing it's going to beat up very soon. By the way, if you're going to put your dryer in dryer your sheets, if you're not drying that online like we do, your elastic polyester elastic will be worn out like as soon as that new one what you bought sheet and it's already worn out. 3 washings, 4 washings maybe with dryer, and that's it. This vintage one, cotton one, will not. No, well, that's why I suggest to find this one. But don't just buy it because it says vintage. Because if it was not storaged properly, like elastic shoot, when I'm in that video, I explain to you, it's going to be already beat up and no good. No, well, it has to be storaged properly for years and years to be available to have this. It's a cotton with embedded elastane in it. It's something just like impossible to find, but still China have it. Still China have it on those storage houses. You can order it from them. And well, let's see how we can put it in. First of all, where to put it? This is your fitted sheet, right? And where to put it? Well, you're going to put it right here on the bottom of the sheet, obviously. You're going to put it like about 1/3 of this distance from corner to corner right here, all around this side, and the same way there. You got it? 1/3 of this size of it, around that corner, and here and 1/3 here. That's how you do it. If you put it flat like that, this is your corners right here. You're gonna put your elastic 1/3 of this distance. You go put elastic right here, finish. Right here, finished. Don't put right here in the middle, because otherwise, especially if you're not using vintage elastic, you'll be not available to stretch it over. It will be too small. Okay, let's do it. Let me show you how far to stretch elastic. All right, guys, let me zoom up for you what you can see, what I'm doing with how I'm stitching actually. And well, here you are. When you found where to start it, right? You found where to start it. You started back and forward, make sure it's not gonna rip right away, because you have to pull it. Then you pull it. How much you pull it? As much as you can possibly. Of course, you're going from backwards, okay? And just stitch to the hem of that. of this side of sheet, and you stretch it like that as far as can get, and go from point to point, just like I showed you. And that's what you got. That's what you got. As you can see, I did not even change to match color in my bobbin, because it's subtle. That I'm too practical woman to do that. Don't have to match perfect, because it's go right under my tucking under my foam mattress. Nobody will ever see it. No, well, that's what you do. And you, why you stretch it to maximum? Because you washing a few times, elastic will stretch on its own, because that's what beat up elastic. Washing and special dryer. If you have chance, please wash your expensive, I know how expensive they are, 300 and 600 count cotton, really Egyptian cotton sheets, very expensive. That's why be good to yourself. Even if you have money, take care of this stuff. You know, you don't have to waste money completely on something which is so easy to fix it. No, well, make it last what you spend money on. Thank you, guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe if you're not subscribed yet. More than 200 videos on the channel, and a lot, like 2 dozen playlists already. And thank you for